take some calls from the request line. Caller number one.
Hey, man, what's up? This Dominique from Saying No Tampon.
What's up, Dominique?
I'm with that song for the Petey Pablo.
All right, I got that coming right up for you. Now, shout out to the radio station that gave you what you wanted.
Man, got around. OG Silverback here. Hey guys, had to stop this video here because I have to give a discretionary warning. Adult content. Proceed forward only if you're 18 or above and you're not offended by sexually explicit content or lyrics. Guys, this song here by Petey Pablo is called Freek-A-Leek, and it's the explicit version. On one of my videos, I found it on YouTube, and it was the clean-cut television version. But you need to listen to the explicit version because it's a teachable moment for the name of this video, which I have titled, The Economics of Hypergamy, Female Hypergamy 101 for Incels, TFLs, Mgtows, and PUAs, or say wannabe PUAs. So guys, I'm going to break this song down here for you because it's got a lot of teachable moments. And one thing I want the TFLs and the incels to understand, and even the Mgtows who are confused at the way hypergamy works, is this. If you got the money and the power in your area, then you can get a woman to do whatever the fuck you want her to do, however you want her to do it, and she'll think it's a great idea. But if you're a guy, you come up, you got no social value, you don't have any higher status than her, or you don't have any money or power, or you're not an influencer of the men in your area, in your tribe, then she's going to think what you say to her is offensive. She may slap you. She may call the cops on you. Because hypergamy, it's like having rose-colored glasses on for women. And I made a video a couple weeks ago. I wanted to explain to you about how hypergamy really quick. Oh, this is really for you incels and TFLs, even for some of you Mgtow guys, and it's even for some of you PUA guys. I did an experiment. It was from this guy called Major Mark, who he had a business with Ross Jeffries back in the 80s. And Ross Jeffries was a software programmer, so he understands how to write code. If you understand how to write code, you understand logic. Because computers are based off of logic. Women are based off emotion. And this guy, Mark, Major Mark, he ran a successful hypnosis business, dude, where he had female clients, man. And he would hypnotize them, man, for therapeutic reasons. So him and Ross Jeffries came together to put together a product where they did the hypnosis of the women, but it wasn't for therapeutic reasons. It was so you can bust some nuts in any woman that you want. Because you had these language patterns called NLP, Neuro-Linguistic Programming. That's where it comes from, Ross Jeffries. He's the beast mode dude because he did some Ericksonian stuff, man. And he's a deep dude, man. He's a scientist, man. He's a psychiatrist. So anyway, what happens is if you understand how that works, then... I did this experiment when I bought the course for $15,000. So what happens is, I'm gonna use San Francisco for an example, right? So San Francisco is a pretty big metropolis, man. Any big city you go to has got an east side, a west side, a north side, and a south side. So let's just take San Francisco. Let's say I live in downtown. I used to live in downtown San Francisco off of a street called Valencia. I used to live on top of Gold's Gym because that's back when I was a champion powerlifter and bodybuilder. So I did like Arnold when I came to California. I lived on top of a gym. That's another story. So anyway, I'm in downtown San Francisco. Let's call that the hub. So what I did was I went to the north side of San Francisco. Like, I got up in the morning. I didn't take a shower. I didn't brush my teeth. I didn't shave. I didn't comb my hair. And all I did was I threw on a t-shirt from the night before when I had a pizza party with my buddies. It was our cheat day. So we were eating the kind of pizza where you just fold it together and it's so hot and greasy. You drop grease on your t-shirt, man, and then we had some hot dogs and stuff and ate those, mustard squirted on my sweatpants, and then I just had on some rundown tennis shoes that I used to run in the mornings, had mud on them, right? So I went to the north side of San Francisco, and I went into the most popular mall there, and I walked through the mall, and I was trying to make eye contact with women. This is the exercise that I did, that Major Mark suggested. And so I walked slouched over, and I just was had my head down, and I would look up just enough to try to get eye contact. I had slouchy posture, you know, and I shuffled my feet when I walked. Long story short, guys, I didn't get any eye contact or IOIs, which is indicators of interest. So then what I did, guys, is I ran home, like Major Mark suggested, dude. I took a shower, man, brushed my teeth really, really good, slicked my hair back with some cool gel. And back then I used to shop at this place called Banana Republic because I'm from Puerto Rico. And they had some cool, like, nice shirts, man. So I put on a nice, loud-colored, like, patterned silk shirt. Then I had on some nice khakis. But I had on some nice Docker shoes, man. And I had on a nice, back then I had a Citizen watch, man, and a nice gold chain, right? And I freshly shaved and everything. And I put oil all over my body, dude. And I put on some cool-ass fucking Ray-Ban shades, man. So then I went to the south side of San Francisco. Went to the major mall there. And this time when I walked, I stood up really, really straight, stuck my chest out, shoulders back, head up. And I took long, relaxed strides, man, making sure to swivel my hips, man. You know what I mean? Like George Clooney. And I was walking through, and I made eye contact with 80% of the women there. I got IOIs. Not only that, I had women commenting on my shirt, like, oh, the pattern of your shirt. It's so exotic, and it's just the material is nice, and it's a sexy shirt. So my experience was totally opposite, just based on hypergamy. I was the same guy, I dressed more upscale. I had on some trinkets that, you know, made it look like I had money, and I slicked my hair back and brushed my teeth, put on some Ray-Bans, you know, and I had on some, you know, this is a nice outfit, man. I carried myself in a way that is called act as if. Like, how would you carry yourself if you were the best version of yourself? So that's what I want to tell you, incels and TFLs, about hypergamy, dude. Here's the economics of it. He who has the money, the status, or the power gets the women, and women will do whatever you ask them to do. That's why they don't feel it's offensive. But if you got low status, man, good luck. Now when he tells her, can you do it from the front? Can you do it from the back? Can you break it down like that? That's not really a question. He's asking her in a way like, are you gonna do it? And she'll do it. So don't get it confused, guys. He's posing it like that just to put the lyrics of the song. But the reason he's bringing it up, because she's going to do it. Because he's got the money and the status and the power. Here we go. 24, 34, 40, 60, thick, and what you get, she'll work, she'll work. Pretty face and some cute lips, earring and a tongue, and she know what it do. Got a name for herself, and she do a shit well, and know how to... Well, let me share something with you guys here, guys. I'm going to play the whole song for you, but this is a play-by-play moment, but... I don't know if you guys ever played a sport, or you did martial arts, or you took a dance lesson, or you played an instrument. Any of those things is called practice makes perfect. Imperfect practice makes perfect, right? So he says in the video, she's got a ring on her tongue and she knows what to do with it. And when you run into a woman, dude, that puts it on you, dude, you got to say to yourself in the back of your head, like, you know. I mean, you got to get past that. Hey, man, I'm so lucky, man. Like, she knows what to do. You got to get past that voice and be like, damn, she's got a lot of fucking experience, man. She's had a lot of dudes teaching her just what to do. Because them type of skills, women just don't learn them innately, dude. They learn practice makes perfect. Now here, check this out, dude. He said she come over anytime a dude call, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 in the morning. So now, if a chick's not into you, man, because You know, you don't have the higher status as a higher status male, or you don't have, you know, the power or the money, or, you know. Man, you can call her 1 to 2 o'clock, man. She's calling out a booty call. She ain't going to come over. So girls are full of shit, dude. Because if a woman's into you, man, hypergamously, and she knows you got the money and you can elevate her lifestyle, she'll do whatever the fuck you want her to do. And this is what I ran into. The reason I'm making this video, guys, is because even though you understand hypergamy and you practice it to win, don't end up like I was when I was making 200 G's a year. I was getting whores, man. I met my ex-wife. And, dude, she did whatever I asked her to do. I used to do ass to mouth, fuck her 5-6 times a day, fuck her in the car, fuck her in the theater, stop elevators, fuck her in the park. Just crazy shit, right? Just crazy shit. Freaky shit, bro. She used to suck my fucking cock. You know how you're coming when your cock's in the woman's mouth and they start going, like sucking it even harder, trying to suck all the fucking cum out of your balls. Woo! She did all that until we got married, bro. And then once she had a fucking kid, all that shit changed, guys. You see the change in my voice? All the bass is out of that because she turned me into a bitch. So that's the part you got to be careful about. That's why I don't agree with marriage, dude, because once you marry a whore, man, then she's got the power. And once you give a whore a baby, if you don't have, like, an agreement beforehand, you're giving her the power, too. So learn from my mistakes, guys. But just know that to trap you, a woman will do all that if she views you as a high-status male. Now, here we go. He's talking about smoke a little coke, take a little hit, drink a little, smoke a little weed, drink a little, right? So I'm just sharing this with you because now in the news, man, you got all these guys that are being, from Kavanaugh to Bill Cosby to a bunch of others, man, are being accused of, you know, seducing women with drugs, man. I made another video on this, guys, that women are the main progenitors of drug use and alcohol use. When I lived in Project Los Angeles, dude, it was a lair with 5 natural pickup artists. I was the only one studying PUA. The rest of them just natural lady killers, bro. Every time we had whores come over, which was every night, it was always the whores would bring over, like, the drugs, man. Coke, weed, fucking all kind of drink. You know what I mean? And I told a story with you guys that before I was clean and sober because I'm high off of life, and the girls would get strange. They'd act weird when I didn't get high with them, bro. And back when my game wasn't as tight, I would break down and just do enough to get them in the bedroom. But I'm just saying that women, dude, they got fucking, it's all situational. If they like you, you can do no wrong. But if they don't like you, even if you look at them and you're cross at it, they're going to accuse you of something that you didn't do. Now here's another thing, man. Like, and I'm sharing this with you, TFLs and Incels and even Mgtow guys that have an experience, and you want to be PUAs. I say want to be, because if you're really a natural, you don't need to be a PUA. But man, women. All women are bisexual, guys. Just, I gotta tell you that, because a lot of guys don't know that, and they're all like, stop the record, like that, you know? Like the record scratching back in the old days when they had a 33 and a third record that spun around on a spindle. Yeah, all women are bisexual, dude. I know because I grew up with a sister, I grew up with female cousins, and I used to see their sleepovers in the fucking, I mean, like, when's the last time you had your homies when you're, let's say you're 12 or 13, buddy. Let's say they even say 10 or 11 and you got your homeboys sleeping over with you. When's the last time you took some cotton balls and put them between each one of his toes and then you did his toenails for him? And when is the last time you let your homeboy sit down in between your thighs, man? Like you're sitting on the couch, he's sitting down in between your thighs watching TV, his head in between your legs by your nutsack, and you're doing his hair for him. You're washing it, you're brushing it and combing it for him. When's the last time you gave your homie a nice hug, man? And you grab him and you turn him side to side. You go, oh, like that. And you kiss him on the cheek. When's the last time you did that? Or when's the last time you cuddled up with your homie, you spoon with him while you guys watch a movie. Now, you may think I'm being ludicrous. I'm telling you what the fuck I saw growing up with a lot of female, hot female cousins that had sleepovers every fucking weekend. And with a sister, I seen how the girls play. And they just, man, one thing can lead to a fucking other. And I bring that up because when I say that to you, you feel how ludicrous it is because you would never do that. But just imagine if you did do that, how just imagine you got some drinks and your one thing can lead to another. But girls, once they start licking the pussies out, they start kissing each other. It's like, because Katy Perry's got a song called I Kissed a Girl and I Liked It. And then they had this move, they had this series called Humans about these androids, man. Yeah, I think they were conscious androids, man. The one lady started making out with another human lady. And it's just, this whole bisexual theme is coming up because women innately are bisexual, dude. Like, when you got these kings and sheiks that have harems of women, like, dude, if you're like King Solomon or King David or you're a sheik, let's be honest here, guys, you got 500 women. Like, I've seen his movies, I've seen these, I'm sorry, these, reality shows about Mormon dudes that marry like three women, or maybe they got five women, right? So you might think to yourself, hypothetically, like, okay, he's banging Susie on Monday, he's banging Sally on Tuesday, he's banging Yvette on Wednesday, he's banging Patricia on Thursday, and then he's banging Betsy on Friday, right? Okay, you got that rotation now. Let me tell you something about woman's sexual appetite, dude. So when you banging Sally on Monday, if you think she's gonna remain like locked up and celibate to you rotate around again, you're fucking deluded. She will call the other wives over and they'll have a pussy licking fest. Yeah, a pussy licking fest. I know because I had three girlfriends. Two of them were bisexual and one was gay. After coming to know me, she figured out she was bisexual. And I seen how they were like, oh, you know, OG Silverback, I care so much about you, I want to have secrets. Well, what's on your mind, girl? Well, you know, it's just something it's something I like to do. What's that? Well, I like girls. I like girls too. No, but I like them like the same way you like them. Oh, really? Yeah, and I don't want to keep a secret. Can I, you mind if I bring my girlfriends over? And she'd bring her girlfriends over. And then I watch them licking each other. And then check this out, guys. I go up and join in there. And going up in both of them, you know? And maybe it was three of them. And then, I mean, how many nuts can you bust? Let's say you bust five nuts. Then you're done. Then they're still licking each other, dude. And putting feathers on each other and hot wax. All kind of dildos on each other. Vibrators. Anyway, let's continue. So anyway, guys, I encourage you to I encourage you to replay this video because if you count the names if you count the names that he's counting off, he's already up to like 10 or 15 of them, dude. And so the way hypergamy works, fellas, he who has the money has the honey. And it's just like I put some links on here. And the reason I got caught up on this thing is because, you know, as I'm doing research on the internet, I'm a watch fiend, dude. Like, I like to buy watches. And just so you guys know, man, I'm not going to lie to you, man. Like, when I was balling out of control, the money was coming in so quickly. I was getting, man, I remember I was making well over $10,000 a month, dude. So, and my living expenses were $2,000 a month. So then I had $8,000 left over, man. This was after taxes, of course. This was net. So, dude, when you got that kind of money, man, when your living expenses are $2,000, like, that paid my rent, my gas, my car payment, my bills, my food, all that. And then I had money just left over, and then back then I was telling females, like, well, I need to buy you anything because I got females to buy me whatever I want. So I used to make them take me to dinner, take me on trips, whatever. I was pimping them because I learned from pimps. I'm not spending my money. But the moral of the story is, dude, I used to buy a lot of shoes and watches. Like, that was my thing, dude, because my mentor who groomed me says when a man first meets you, the first thing he does is he looks at the type of suit you have on. So I used to wear a lot of $5,000 suits, bro. And they fit. Let me tell you something. A $5,000 suit fits way differently than a $500 suit. So my boss was like, get the best quality suits, shoes, and watches. Because a man, when you meet him, back then I had to go and give presentations for my company as a vice president to get these $1 million contracts. Of course, I wouldn't get the million. It was for the company, but I would get a nice bonus off of it. So anyway, my boss is like, yeah, the first thing he does, he looks at you, the car you drive up in. So I had a Lexus and a Jaguar, right? And then he said, then they look at your suit, they look at your briefcase, they look at your shoes and your watch. So I was a watch and a shoe fanatic. So I got a homeboy of mine, he gets all kind of Rolexes and stuff off of the internet. Rolexes and Bentley, what is it called? Breitling Bentleys and stuff like that. And he's just a watch fanatic, man. And so he's got a $45,000 Rolex and a $10,000 Rolex, and he's got a $5,000 Rolex. So anyway, guys, I'm a watch fiend, so I like to get a lot of different, like, cool watches and stuff, man. And let me just tell you something, man. I was doing some research to get another Rolex, right? And so I came across this ad that they have now, man, with this dude named Wiz Khalifa. He's a big time rapper, but he was saying, no, he said, when you got a Rolex, that equals more sex, more drugs, and more relaxation. So the subconscious message is, when you can afford a Rolex, you ballin', so your lifestyle is elevated, right? With money comes power, like I said, women and everything, dude, with money. That's why I'm trying to help you guys understand the importance of getting your money on, man. So anyway, when I was searching for Rolexes, they got this ad campaign where they got these fucking whores that actually wear these t-shirts that say no Rolex, no shirt. And so then when I saw that, that's when I had to make this video for the Incels and the TFLs and the Mgtows, man, and the wannabe PUAs. Because a lot of Mgtow guys, man, the reason I include you guys, man, because you guys are hard workers. A lot of Mgtow guys, let me tell you something, what I like about Mgtow guys, that what I like about them is their downfall with women. A lot of Mgtow guys are very frugal with their money. So what that means is, if a Mgtow guy is making $100,000 a year, he's not going to live really affluently. He's going to get a nice house, nothing too extravagant. He's going to get a nice car, nothing too big ballerish. He's not going to be wearing Rolexes and stuff. He might get a Timex. He's not going to be wearing $5,000 suits. He might be wearing like $500 suits. And he's going to live very modestly, because Mgtow men, they're the real, in my opinion, the real old school American men that built this country and that made it great. The only thing what happened with the Mgtow guys is, with their old school philosophies of hard work and doing what's right and playing by the game and playing by the rules, they had their head down so far doing what they needed to do as men. They didn't look up and see how society was changing, where whores run shit, where whores now want a free ride. They don't want to put no work in. They don't even respect work. What a whore respects is, if you're dumb enough to fucking give her a baby and fucking marry her, you're that fucking stupid. She respects to take all your fucking shit. And while you're so busy working, you Mgtow guys, that you passed that sexual revolution. I was a part of it, because my fucking ex-wife raped me and took me to cleaners, took all my shit. And then when I came out of it, I was lucky enough to get turned on to the PUA community right after I was turned on to Mgtow. So Mgtow guys don't like this just blow money on stupid shit, man. And American women, they want you to spend money on them. And that's why Mgtow guys have a disconnect with females. And that's why I'm making this video here, because I want all you guys to understand something. When you have the appearance of having money, you're going to have the pussy. It's that simple. You ain't even got to have game.
With your feet crammed to the head, you want it from the back, put your face in the pillow so you can yell as loud as you want to.
That's one thing I gotta share with all you guys, you TFLs and you incels, as you listen to me, and even you Mgtow guys, man. You wanna be all you guys fall in the same fucking category, because what happens is, I wanna share this with you, man. There's a difference between positive thinking and positive knowing. So here's positive thinking. Like, you Mgtow guys been to college, and you know that if you do everything right, you're going to get a good job, and then you're going to be able to get a nice car and a nice house. And you PUA guys are positively thinking that if you learn the all the tips and the tricks, man, and what to say, you know, and the pickup lines, that you're going to be successful with women. And you TFLs are positively believing that one day you're going to find the love of your life. And you incels are positively believing that, you know, things are going to change, and you know, they'll accept you for who you are, the women, right? I'm positively knowing. I'm like the guy who's climbed Mount Everest like 10 times, because that's just how I roll. I like challenging myself. I went to the top of Mount Everest, came back down, went back up, came back down. And so when I'm at the base of Mount Everest, there's some young guys coming, and they've been reading all this positive personal development stuff. And so, I positively believe, OG, that I can climb to the top of Mount Everest and take a picture, take a selfie. I'm like, have you ever done it? No, but I positively believe in myself. And here's me. I've positively done it so many times. So just, if you want to learn some shit, follow my example, and I'll show you exactly what I did. Because the best way to learn something is to mirror somebody who's already did it. And then once you've done it a couple times, then you can go ahead and reverse engineer everything. So here we go, guys. On the floor, do you want it on the chair? Do you want it over here? Do you want it over there? Do you want it in your pussy? Do you want it in your ass? Anything you can handle. Shamika, Keisha, Sarah, Shania, Sabrina, Crystal, Rhonda, Lisa, Felicia, Felicia, Shamara, Monique, Christina, Yolanda.
Shout out to Sysbm, cause I drink it and they pay me for it. Freek-A-Leek, Shamika, Keisha, Tara, Shania, Sabrina, Crystal, Dorinda, Lisa, Felicia, Tanisha, Siobhan, Freek-A-Leek, Monique, Christina, Yolanda. Freek-A-Leek, Shamika, Keisha.
And you keep hearing the woman. You know, you keep hearing a woman saying, how you like a daddy? How you like a daddy? Right? She's asking, how you like a daddy? And then when he said, can you take it from the front? She's like, yeah, daddy, can you take it from the back? Yeah, daddy, I'm gonna break it down like that. Yeah, give it to me, daddy. He licked my balls. Yeah, daddy. You understand? That's hypergamy 101, guys. And what I did was, I put this music video in there. It's called the Explicit Virgin, dude. And this shows this dude, Petey Pablo, before he made it big. Because a lot of these guys was rapping, and they were selling their rap tapes out of the back of their cars, like their CDs and DVDs. I'm gonna put a link into 50 Cent's movie to show how he came up hustling like that. And then once they make it big, they got to clean it up in order to get it played on the radio, man. So, I mean, on Mtow and BET, right? So then I'm going to show you the explicit version. And you look at dude, he's straight hood from the street. He's no joke. But then I want you to see how he looked once Hollywood and the music industry cleans him up. And you listen to the clean version. But then I'm going to put the lyrics in there as well, guys. But the moral of the story, you TFLs, incels, and Mgtows and wannabe PUAs, stay tuned with me, so I'm going to help you to get your money right, dude. Because once you get your money right, everything else will come to you, guys. Because this is what Jim Rohn says. He said he became a millionaire not because of the money, but what it made him become as a person. Until next time, OG Silverback, out.